Your Honor, I'd like to address a separate issue.
All right.
Your Honor, Detective Furman's going to play a very small role in this case. But we believe when he's called to the stand, we're going to be forced to go back 15-odd years to ask him about completely irrelevant statements that people have claimed he's made. Now, these statements are racially insensitive and divisive. The question is, why bring them up? Now, they're going to ask him if he made a racial slur or repeated a racial epithet. But why ask? Now, there's no legal purpose for it. But Mr. Cochran and the defense have a purpose for entering this area. And that purpose is to inflame the passions of the jury and ask them to pick sides. The N-word is a dirty, filthy word, Your Honor. It is so prejudicial and inflammatory that the use of it in any situation will evoke an emotional response from any African American. We're talking about a word that blinds people. When you mention that word to this jury, it will blind them to the truth. They won't be able to discern what's true and what's not. It will impair their judgment. It will affect their ability to be fair. It'll force the black jurors to make a choice. Whose side are you on? The man or the brothers?
Is he serious?
So the people strongly urge the court, respectfully, not to allow that vile word to be uttered at any time during this trial.
Your Honor, I did not plan to speak on this matter, but I would be remiss if I did not respond to my good friend, Mr. Chris Darden. Mr. Darden's remarks this afternoon are perhaps the most incredible remarks I have heard in a court of law in my 32 years of practice. His remarks are deeply demeaning to African Americans, and so first and foremost, Your Honor, I would like to apologize to African Americans across this country. It is preposterous to say that African Americans collectively are so emotionally unstable that they cannot hear offensive words without losing their moral sense of right and wrong. They live with offensive words, offensive looks, offensive treatment every day. And so, Your Honor, I am ashamed that Mr. Darden would allow himself to become an apologist for Mark Furman. Who are any of us to testify as an expert as to what words black people can or cannot handle? Your Honor, across America, believe you me, African Americans are offended at this very moment. And so for a friend that I deeply respect, I would say this was outlandish, unfortunate, and unwarranted.